But Sagarika, coming to you, Mamata Banerjee, right after the verdict in Karnataka, said, "Congratulations to the winners in Karnataka." She did not name the BJP, but she went on to say, "Had the JDS and the Congress fought this together, the results would have varied a lot." What does this tell you? Is the opposition that was supposed to be this anti-Modi bloc miffed with the Congress? Are they trying to send out a message to Rahul Gandhi? Are they unaccepting of his leadership? What does this really mean? What is the statement supposed to mean? Because she's echoing the sentiment of many other constituents of the anti-Modi bloc.
Very right, Supriya. The fact is, the Congress has been thrashed. It's a humiliating defeat. It's a remarkable win for the BJP. I think we're looking in Mr. Modi at the rise of a pan-Indian campaigner. He's punching way above his party. It was he who really swung this for the BJP. I was there. There was a clear pre-Modi, post-Modi factor to this election in Karnataka. Before Mr. Modi arrived, it was lackluster. There was no leadership. It was confused. There was no narrative. And the minute Mr. Modi arrived, those 21 blitzkrieg rallies, and the BJP was galvanized, and the BJP swung into winning mode. So I think he swung it for the party. Mr. Modi has swung this for the BJP. And I think we're seeing the rise of a presidential pan-Indian kind of campaigner in Mr. Modi. And as China NCA said, the BJP for the first time breaching the Vindhyas, seeking, getting a foothold in beyond the Vindhyas on its own. In 2008, it had Yeduriappa's sympathy wave, but this time on its own, Mr. Modi has got this victory. So it's a remarkable achievement for the BJP, thrashing for the Congress. I think what is going to happen now, Supriya, going forward into 2019, is the leadership of the Congress of the anti-Modi front is going to be questioned. Mamata Banerjee, we know, has been openly batting for the JDS. She said, even on polling day, that the Congress should have allied with the JDS. KCR backing JDS. So I think we're going to see every state satrap now say, "We don't accept the leadership of Rahul Gandhi or Congress. We're going to fight Modi on our own. Why should we have the leadership of the Congress when it's a losing proposition?" So I think the leadership of the Congress in 2019 of the anti-Modi secular front, if I can call it that, is in serious doubt now. I think it's the federal players, the federal partners, the regional satraps who are looking for a kind of united front 1988, 1999, 98 moment where a united front forms the government and challenges Modi without the Congress.